Hi, welcome to part one of the mapp unit management tutorial. In this tutorial, we'll learn how to manage units using mapp components. Mapp services components now support unit management. Alarm messages in mapp alarm X, for example, can also display the respective units. In mapp audit, the units used for defined variables can be displayed and exported in the event list. In mapp data, you can log process variables along with their units. All mapp components follow the same underlying principle. In the following example, we're going to log a temperature variable using mapp data. The unit should then be visible in the exported file. To define the unit for a variable, you must define both the engineering unit and the display unit. The engineering unit is what is used to process the variable in the application. The display unit is what is displayed with the process variable on an HMI screen or in an export file. We'll start by defining the engineering unit. Later on, we'll modify the display unit. The unit is specified in the OPC UA default view configuration. The variable must be enabled for OPC UA communication. The temperature variable should be defined as an engineering unit in degrees Celsius. The unit defined here is the engineering unit. In order to use the unit system, the OPC UA server must be enabled on the target system. In addition, the user role system must be added, and the user anonymous assigned the role everyone. For more information, see Automation Help. Automation Studio has three standard systems of units: the metric system, the imperial system, and the US imperial system. The temperature variable also needs to be displayed with the correct unit based on the defined unit system. That means the next step is to define the display unit. If using the metric system, the variable should be displayed in Celsius. If the Imperial or Imperial US system is selected, the process variable will be displayed in Fahrenheit. The relationship between the system of units and the display unit for the process variable is set in the MPComUnit configuration. The desired variable is specified under data points. We'll select the temperature variable. Depending on the system of units, the unit must be specified in the form of a unit code. For information about units and the corresponding unit codes, see Automation Help. The conversion from Celsius to Fahrenheit takes place automatically. The variable is now ready to be used in mapp components. The concept section for each component explains important considerations with regard to unit management. As we explained at the beginning, we want to log the variable using mapp data, and its unit should be displayed properly in the log. For an explanation of how to use mapp data, see parts 1 and 2 of the mapp data tutorial. The system of units that should be used in mapp data is defined in the configuration under unit definition. We'll set the measurement system to metric. Unit display indicates how the unit of the process variable should be displayed in mapp data. You can display the full name of the unit, an abbreviation, or no unit at all. Once we download our changes to the controller, we're ready to test the project. First, we'll enable monitor mode. The recording has been started as explained in part 2 of the mapp data tutorial. The infrastructure of MP Data Recorder shows us that a recording is available. And as we can see, the temperature variable was recorded, and so was the desired unit. As you can see, it's very easy to manage units using mapp components. Thanks for watching.